Assalamu alaikum everyone. So today's lecture is our lecture number 8, which is about the socket and socket programming. In this lecture we will discuss what is a socket, what is socket programming, what is port number, and how socket programming is done. We will be having the examples in Python language, in Python. Okay. The socket programming can be done in two ways, that is reliable or unreliable, and in this lecture we will see how it is done. Let's begin. So firstly we will see what is a socket. In networks there are three addressing schemes, or there are three type of addresses which are used to identify certain things. Firstly is the IP address, which represent the logical address. IPs consist of two type of versions, version 4 and version 6. Version 4 consists of 32 bits and version 6 consists of 128 bits. So IP address gives you the logical address of the device. Then second type of address in network which is used is MAC address, or we will call it a physical address. It gives the physical address of the device. And third type of addresses are the port numbers or the socket numbers. Usually they are called the port numbers. Port number differ from application to application. They basically every application has its own port number. For example, we will see in the lecture that different applications like FTP has its own port number, then HTTP has its own port number, and then so on. So what is a socket? Socket basically is an interface that is between the application layer, is between the application and the network. It provides an interface or a gateway or a doorway between the application and the network, or the process and the network. So the application or the process creates a socket so that it can go through that doorway to the below layers and then further on to the network. So the application creates a socket. Every application has its own socket. So the type of socket decides what type of communication has been taking place. For example, if the application has to be the reliable data transfer, that means there can be no loss, however the delay can be tolerated. So that type of application will have a different socket type. On the other hand, if an application requires there can be no guarantee of service or no guarantee of packet delivery, then it will have a other socket type. I basically means that if you are using a TCP type of service, then the socket type will be different, and if you are using a UDP based socket or UDP based service, then the socket type will be different, and that will decide what type of communication has been taking place. So basically there are two type of sockets. In case of application there are reliable transfer of application or unreliable or the best effort, and in terms of connection there are two type of connection services, that is the connection oriented or the connectionless service. So the socket determines is based on which type of communication has been taking place. So once the socket has been configured by the application, then the data is to be transferred to the network for the transmission onto the physical layer and then onto the physical medium. So the socket receives the data which is being delivered to him by the lower layers at the receiving end. So that will be transmitted through the network and then will be received at the receiving end, and then eventually it will be transferred to the relevant socket number, and then it will be transferred to the relevant process or the application number. So there are two types of sockets. TCP or reliable delivery of service sockets, and then UDP or unreliable delivery of service sockets. In TCP based sockets, the packet ordering or the segments ordering has to be done in order, and the order cannot be tolerated. So if the segment is missing, then it will be retransmitted so that the missing segment can be rearranged and can make the data in order. Whereas in UDP based service, there is no order guarantee. The segments can receive out of order, and there is no connection being established in UDP. However, in TCP, before transmission of data, connection is being made between the sender and the receiver, or the client and the server. TCP is a bidirectional service, and yes, UDP can send or receive at the same time. So you can see in the diagram as well. So now let's move on to the ports. So what is port? I have discussed that there are port numbers. So IP addresses are basically 32 or 128 bits addresses, and then MAC address is of 48 bits. So ports basically determine which type of application you are using, and the size of port is 16 bits. So you can have maximum of 65,536 ports on each host starting from zero. That means the maximum port number can be 65,535. So some ports are reserved for specific type of applications. So there are free ports and there are reserved ports. Reserved ports are being monitored by IETF, and those are cannot be utilized for other type of purposes. For example, if file transfer has to be made, then it should be on port number 20 or 21, and HTTP service is to be given on 80 port, and telnet service is to be on 23 port. So these are the reserved port numbers specifically for specific type of services, and there are free port numbers from around 2000 port onward. So a socket provides an interface between the network and a port. So the data has to be transferred through the port to the network. So basically socket is a doorway or an opening between the process and the network. So what will be our goal in socket programming is to learn how to build a client server application that will communicate using the socket. And the client server application can be of UDP or TCP based. So the communication can be in peer-to-peer based architecture, but here the application mostly are client server, so we are using it. But the peer-to-peer architecture can also have the socket program. So socket is a door between application process and the end-to-end transport loop. Okay. So you can see that process or the application wants to deliver the data to the network, then a socket is being created so that the data or the process or the message can be transported onto the transport layer and then eventually onto the network layer. So in this, the application developer controls usually the process part, and the transport layer, network layer, link layer, and the physical layer are being controlled by the operating system. So in socket programming, there are two types of services, UDP based services or the TCP based services. So let's assume an example in which the client wants the data in the uppercase from the server. So basically the client is entering the data in the lowercase alphabets, and then the server is receiving that lowercase alphabet input from the client and then converting it onto the uppercase and then delivering the data back to the client, and then client just printing the data after the conversion into uppercase. So in this example, let's assume this type of communication, and in which client server is been communicating. And now we will discuss how client server application will be developed using the socket programming. So in first step, the client will read or input the data using the keyboard and then send the data to the server. So the server will receive the data and converts it into the uppercase. Then this modified data in the uppercase is been sent to the client by the server, and then the client receives the modified or the uppercase version and then displays onto the screen. So these are the four steps, and then let's move on and how these four steps are being performed using socket programming. So if we are doing socket programming using unreliable service, that means the connection will not be taking place before the data communication. There will be no connection between the client and the server. There will be no handshaking before the sending of data, which means there will be no connection setup. And the sender explicitly attached the IP address and the port number to each packet. Okay, and then the receiver will extract the sender IP address and port number from the received packets and will process onto the request. So the UDP based transmission, in this the data can be transmitted, the transmitted data can be lost or can be received out of order. This type of application usually used where we want the communication to be faster instead of being reliable. So how this interaction will be done using UDP in the client, in the socket programming? So the server side will be on this and the client side will be on this. So first step will be creating the port or the socket. Why? Because the process want to communicate with the client or data has to be shared. Okay, so first step will be creating the socket, and then the server socket will be assigned using this socket Python based command. And then firstly the server will create its own socket, and then or the port, and then client end will create its own socket, and then the created data graph, because client wants to convert the data into uppercase. Okay, so the lowercase data or the data graph will be sent using the client socket. Client will send the lowercase data using his client socket, and then what will the server do? It will receive the data graph from the server socket, which is being created at the server. And then after receiving the data in the lower case, converting it back into the upper case, and then the reply will be sent to client using the server socket, which will specify the client number and the specific port number of the client. And then client will receive the datagram from the client socket, and then it will close the client socket because the data has been received and there is no more requirement to open or keep the connection alive, so that it cannot be used for other hacking or other type of security lapses. So the socket has been closed here and whole communication has been taking place. So if this category is being used using TCP, there will be our flow or the total algorithmic overview to the UDP based client socket interaction. We will look into the example as well on the programming side. So if this socket programming has to be done in TCP, then firstly client must contact the server first, server process must be running, and the server must have created the socket that will welcome the client request. Okay, so first step the client has to contact the server, and on the server side the server has to create a port, has created a port, and it should welcome the client request. And then secondly, if the client has contacted the server, then clients how it will contact the server? It will contact the server using TCP socket, specifying the IP address, port number of the server, and then the handshaking process will take place that will allow the server to talk with multiple clients, and source port number will distinguish between the clients. So single server port will be communicating with multiple clients port. So the created server port will communicate with the particular client port using their particular client socket numbers. So in this application, in this type of application, the data has to be in order delivered. The connection has to be established before the transmission of data, and after transmission of data, if there are loss of segments or packets, then the lost segment has to be retransmitted so that it can be in reliable form. So how the socket interaction between client and server take place using TCP? Let's begin. Firstly, server has to create the socket to welcome the client. So first step is to create the server socket and then wait for the incoming connection request. In this case, client will create the socket, and then connection has to be established within TCP connection setup. We will look into this TCP connection setup, how it is being processed, and the transport layer section. Then the client will send the request or the data using the client socket, and then server will read the request using connection socket and then reply the connection socket. Then after that, client will receive the data and then close his socket for further connection. So how this programming, let's move on to the program, how this has been taken place. Let me rub it first for you. Okay. So that we can look back. So let's see how the UDP based client application will work. This syntax of programming is being implemented in Python. This type of code is being implemented in Python. So firstly, the server will name its host name, then the port number, and then create the socket in the UDP case. Firstly, the client will have to name the server, and will have to name the server port as well, and have to receive the, basically this, have to know this. Then client will create the socket using this command, and then can get the input from the keyboard, which is being the in the lower case, and then send the message onto the server using the client, their created client socket, and then receive the message from the server port, and then print the modified message, and then after that close. So how server will do, basically it will create the server port, and it will bind, and it will receive the message from the client, and whenever the message has been received, it has to be received until it has to be in loop until it's been received. So it will modify the lowercase message into the uppercase, and then it will send the data. So this is very simple in case of UDP. In case of TCP, first step is same, that client will create the TCP socket and then get the data and then get the modified sentence. But here server has to receive the data and the connection. Until the connection has been established, then it will convert the data, and after that send the data, and it will close the connection. So that was our today's lecture on socket programming.